Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue speaking about RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation, and in today's video we will cover how to integrate NVIDIA NIN microservices with the LangChain and covering another use case of speaking with your documents. In this case, we will look at how to integrate HTML documents into your agent and how to use this information to provide context to your RAG agent. Today, as I mentioned, we will use LangChain in combination with the microservice, NVIDIA microservice, NIM, and as model we will use the Mistral, new version Mistral 8 with 7 billion parameters, one of the latest release from Mistral AI, and as vector store we will use Milbus. We will use as well again the as embeddings the one of the models available developed by NVIDIA, and as I used to do, I prepare an output that later on I will upload to the repo to you, be able later on to download and replicate in your local environment. To as requirements, I will pass you the requirements txt. You can check it's not too much. It's just, well, Jupyterlab, you can forget it. It's just to create an environment, a conda environment, LangChain community, the integration with NVIDIA, Markdownify to transform HTML tables objects into Markdown format, the Milbus client, Sentence Transformers. Today we will use as splitters a Transformers model token the splitter, splitting by token, not by characters like we did on previous examples, and the integration LangChain Milbus to connect our framework LangChain with the Milbus vector store. You need as well to create an account in NVIDIA. If you don't have it, you need an account in NVIDIA as an NVIDIA developer. Then on register into NVIDIA NIM microsystems and get an API. How to get an API? You just go to the main page, reasoning, whatever. You just take one of the models, click on that, and you get API key. Generate an API key, not down. And the account, creating the account in NIN is free. You get the same that happens with other cloud providers. This is not more than, very similar to what other providers offer, like Google with Vertex AI, or Azure with AI Studio, or Gemini, or sorry, in yeah, AI Studio, or Azure Machine Learning Studio, or Amazon with Bedrock. So these services, once you register, you get 1,000 credits, and then on after the credits, you can So after the login, I need to log in again, but once you log in, you get 1,000 credits for free. You can spend them in 1 month, and after that, if you have a company, or you can get you can register your company, you get another additional 4,000 credits that you can spend in 90 days. So you had plenty of time if you had a company account to try all the NIN infrastructure, which is really really well prepared, and case that here we have what we had in NIN is a specialized infrastructure microservices to, well, to provide generative AI and deep learning models, or to serve generative AI or deep learning models using the NVIDIA infrastructure. Obviously, everything accelerated with the NVIDIA GPUs, using the runtimes TensorRT and TensorRT LLM, and also models optimized and converted to the proprietary format of the NVIDIA. Under the hood, Kubernetes and Triton server for inference, etc., etc. So, quite extensive and excellent service. If you can see that, you, and in terms of the performance, probably one of the best, if not the best, in the market today, as they are using their own hardware and using their own products, which are obviously based in accelerate their accelerate model using their own the hardware that they produce. So in using the API, you have access to plenty of models in terms of LLMs. You have as well embeddings models here. Today we will use that one. Oh, that, no, that one, NVIDIA big one. You have visual models, stable diffusion, object detection. Yeah, you had multimodal models, Phi, Florence, Meta, Llama, Neva, and you had also models by industry, simulation, optimization, route optimization, and healthcare. So, as I said, plenty of stuff you have here. You can also explore here using the in the dashboard. You have different how to say grouping, and depending what you are looking for, you can go to one of the sections and find different models for that purpose. So everything is managed using the same SDK. You have SDKs in Python, Node, and well, basic HTTP requests to the API, and you will see how easy it is to use as well the model in combination with LangChain, the SDK in combination with LangChain. In the previous two videos, I used it with the Llama Index, today with LangChain, and well, similar use case scenario. In previous videos, we use PDFs. Today, we are going to use HTML documents. So Milbus is another vector store database, vector database, which is today one of the most popular, but well, in terms of use and for the purpose that we are doing, is pretty similar to others that we use as well in previous videos, like Face, Chroma, or Pinecon, or even Elasticsearch that we used recently. In that purpose, is very similar the use. The integration is with LangChain is working exactly the same that the others. And well, Milbus offers multimodal embeddings as well, which is one of the probably good things on that in comparison with the others. Pinecon offers the same, but it's commercial. Milbus is open source. They offer as well cloud service. Cloud service is pay as you go. And well, you have here is licensed by under LFAI and Data Foundation and Apache Apache 2.0 license. Mistral 8, 7 billion, the latest model Well, they claim that outperformed Llama 2 70 billions and GPT 3.5. Yeah, it's quite good. Yeah, summary at the end. We will cover a little bit how today is becoming very difficult to choose which model to use, commercial, non-commercial. You need to go to very basic requirements, and once you have there, it really is very difficult to choose today which model to use. To do whatever you want to, especially these components, these RAG components, you can deploy it very quickly. This notebook took me practically, I would say, 1 hour, and the most complicated was parse the HTML. The rest it was pretty simple, and then well, everything is going very coordinated today. Either if you use LangChain or Llama Index, if you use APIs from commercial, non-commercial models, it's been very, very, very similar to do it one way or the other way. We will make a small summary at the end, and then with my thoughts about this, and then my opinion is how I see it. But well, let's move first of all through the code, and then the example that we will cover today. So I read my .m file with my keys. I put the key of the NVIDIA API key in my environment variables. We use the chat NVIDIA and NVIDIA embeddings. This is part of the integration of LangChain with NVIDIA AI endpoints, the NIN service. So we instantiate the Mistral 7 billions. This truth. This is fine tuning for instruction version 0.1, max token 1024. And the embedded documents, we use them in NVIDIA Embed QA. So we use as source the NVIDIA final fiscal and financial reports from 2020 to 2024. You can take a look. We are interested in the information, all the information that is contained in text, and then we will parse the tables that there is some of them on the document. As you will see here, so first of all, we prepare the URLs that we will ingest. Then here we have the start URL, title time, and also the tables. In this method, we are going to look for attributes, title, and table. And then if you look at the content, one of the pages, so this is the first quarter 2023. So we want to start the title, and then on the tables. The tables, we will extract first of all the HTML, the table. Here you have a table. Table is everything contained in between these tags. Table. And here you have a formatting class, and also you have the content. No, here you have this is Q1 fiscal 2023 summary. Let me try out 2024, 2020. Come on. First quarter, let me return here, 2023. So you have here the first table, yeah, it's Q1 fiscal 2023 summary, then on GAAP, dollars in billions, Q1 financial year 23, Q4, Q1, QQYY, and then only you check here, you have here Q1 fiscal summary, GAAP, dollars in millions, Q1 financial year 2023, Q4 financial year 2022, Q1, QQYY. This is the this table, this line, so this line, this line, this line. So every table, first of all, we extract the HTML, and then on with the Mac Donify, we transfer the table in HTML to Markdown. Finally, we get all the text with the method getText. For that, we are using Beautiful Soap, VS4. And the methods embedded on that. This we do it per page, and with the content, we are creating a list of tables. Every table, every component of the list contains the URL, the title extracted, all the text, the content extracted in text format, and also the tables. So in the content is not included the tables. And the tables transformed from HTML into text. You can check here, for example, this is the URL, this is the first quarter, and this is the tables transformed into HTML. We can take the first one here and check what we get from the first table. Then on we pass the information that we get per table, and we create a summary using the our LLM, in this case Mistral 8.7b. We create a summary in text, and we replace what we extract, so the table is set, with a summary done by our model. After this parsing and summarization, we had in the list of parsed HTML, we had the same content, the URL, the title, the complete content of the page, the text, and every in the attribute tables, we had the summary the model, the LLM, has done per table contained in that page. Once we had all the information parsed and extracted from the URLs, this is the most complicated part of the video. If you want to stop here, it's okay, because the rest probably you already had seen on previous videos. Because again, that was the most complicated part of the whole exercise. Now we are going to use Milvus again. We are going to use today a sentence transformer, a token text splitter. Usually we use the character text splitter using a character like carry return or dot. We split the text based on that characters, and then we choose a length, chunk length based on characters. In this case, using a sentence transformer model, we will split our text based on tokens. We choose a size of 200 tokens with an overlap of 50. We are going to use this model, and we just simply create the text splitter based in our model, our tokens per chunk and the chunk overland. Here we are going to create in this loop a launching document. The document is based on the text content, and we create additionally a launching document per table, per summary DOM. Using the LLM of every single table contained on that page. So at the end, we will have a number of documents before chunking or splitting that contains all the text of our page and a document per table of that page. Once we had all the documents, we iterate through all the HTML pages that we had downloaded, and then we pass all these pages to our document splitter, token text splitter. Once we had done the splitting, we had 746 documents, and as you can see here, if you take the one is just is part of the first page, is the first quarter of the fiscal 2020 fiscal year. So in total, as I said, we have generated 746, and now we include these documents in our vector store. The same that others, we just instantiate the vector store, and using millbooks from documents, we add documents, the documents, splitted documents, the embedded, this is the NVIDIA model, the collection name, that is NVIDIA Finance, the URI, it can be a TCP IP address if you are running this into a Docker, or if you had a database just for that purpose. Here, for this number of documents, you can create simply a file. This is a MSQLite 3 database, this is a small database that comes with Python, so you create the file, and inside this this small database is containing all the relevant information for that to contain the data that Millbox is using to answer your questions. Once you had all the documents inserted or added to the database, we just make a query to test it, and you get here, we are doing this method is implemented in every single vector store that integrate with LangChain, so it's the same that we may use with Chroma, Face, Pinecone, Neo4j, if you use it as a vector store, whatever you use is containing this method, or similarity search, or similarity of vector search, whatever you are using, all these methods are implemented in all the technologies, like vector store technologies that integrate with LangChain. Here we get by default 5 documents, and as you can see here, what are the 2024 Q3 documents, you can see here. Some of them come from the could come from tables, some other could come from the page content itself. Finally, we create a template. In the template, we just hit system instructions. We pass the context. The context is the documents retrieved from the vector store according, or the most similar content according to the question that you formulate. And we pass here some formatting instructions. And here you pass the question. And this is essentially the template that you make. And we create the prompt template with our input variable, context and questions, and using this template. Here we have a small process which is going to build the context, the formatting the context a little bit. And then on here we have another method to generate the answer. We pass the LLM, the vector store, the template, and our question. We retrieve from our vector store the question. We build the context with the documents that were returned from our vector store. We pass it to the build context. We create the context. The context essentially, as you see, is going to contain the page content with the title and with the URL and source, pass split it or divided or separated by pipes. And this is essentially part of the information. Of the information that you specify here as well on the prompt. And with this, we create our prompt template and we invoke the LLM with our prompt. Once the LLM's answer, we pass the content back to the user. Here we just pass a question, what are the 2024 Q1 revenues, and essentially here what they use for the response, and then it's using this file NVIDIA con news. And as you can see here, this is first quarter 2024, 7,192 million. If you scroll a little bit, you have the number here. So you can ask for the other information enclosed here on this page, and you will see that the quality is really good as well. Okay, that's pretty much all. And as I said before, it's becoming really hard to decide which one is which model to use, which technology use, but because yeah, everything is becoming so similar that the models are really progressing, are really good, all of them. It's really difficult. And then on I just is a speaking loud, no, where how you can choose, no, you for simplicity, as you can see here, you can develop a component, a RAS component in less than 1 hour. You have the infrastructure, the models are tested, they have very good quality, working in with very simple APIs where you don't need to be really an expert to create this. It's really simple to introduce. And then on what I try to say is that depending on the requirements that you have, in many cases it's gonna be easy or really reducing a lot the time to market if you are try to create a product. If you simply use the SDKs that the commercial providers provide, no? Like NIN in this case, you have multiple, you have very good infrastructure, very fast, you have very good models there that are optimized to work in or to run in their infrastructure. You have very simple APIs with integrates with the main frameworks, LangChain, Llama Index. So if you don't have very specific requirements like some of the ones I will mention in a few seconds, the easiest is simply use either this API or OpenAI API, Gemini API or Anthropic API. Why? Because, well, you have models there that you can use for multiple purposes, for parsing information or extracting information from video, from audio, from images, from PDFs, from text. So you had multiple use, you had very powerful models that are, maintained by very powerful teams of engineers. We don't need to reinvent the wheel. We just need to use what is offered to us. We pay the price, pay as you go. Every time the price is lower and lower, using lower per token, lower using the infrastructure. And again, if you don't have any specific requirements, again, the easiest is use these APIs. Really difficult as well to choose one. I'm using, as you follow the channel, I've been using non-commercial, commercial models, Azure, OpenAI, OpenAI SDK, Gemini SDK, some cases as well, Anthropic. We are using a lot of commercial, non-commercial models, the Phi-3, the Llama-3, Mistral, Queen. So it's very, very, all of them are really good. And then on, again, if you don't have very specific requirement, no problems with budget. Well, even if you have problem with budget, using an SDK is very simple. The tokens, the consume, it's not very, very expensive. And the equivalent to provide the same level that one of these SDKs is providing to you just with a service pay as you go. If you plan to do the same with your own infrastructure, I don't think it's gonna be cheaper. Believe me. Yeah, simply to run probably inference with a good speed, the same speed that these providers are offering, to create an infrastructure to just you provide inference to your own users, you need to spend a lot of thousands of dollars. Just to give you an example, to run a node in Azure, for example, or in Google with a T4, which is a small GPU, it's gonna cost you $1,200 per month. Only the machine. I'm not saying all the job that you need to do to create the APIs, the interfaces, the logic to connect in between the different components. So at the time to decide what to use, in my opinion, that is well, how I see. First of all, check the requirements. How you are gonna use these components, these rack components? If you need, for example, an internet connection, is you are able to connect to an SDK? Because why I tell you this? Because some of my requirements are like this. I cannot use, for example, internet connection for any solution I provide. Why? Because some of these applications running on premises without internet connection. Why? Because they are in data centers from governments, and they cannot for security reasons they cannot access. So this is a requirement that is a no-go, for example, for a commercial API. Other requirements that you cannot use GPUs, so you need to run your models in a very in cheap hardware or very low resources hardware, like a smartphone or an embedded device. This is another no-go. You have to use a non-commercial model and quantize, create a you use a runtime that allow to run the model in a CPU. But it's not it to be honest, and this is only my opinion, one of these commercial offering like Nvidia, NIM, or Gemini AI, or Vertex AI, or GPT, or OpenAI SDK, that is more than enough, and you can deploy and create one application with very good outputs and results very quickly, very simple to maintain. You don't need a legion of specialists, data engineers, data scientists, and machine learning engineers to maintain all your infrastructure. If you have other requirements, then on yeah, you need to go there. No way to do that. That is a little bit of reflection, no? After doing some of these videos I'm doing the past months, about the topic, no? How I see, no? It's again very difficult to decide which one, because all of them works really fantastic. The SDKs are really simple to use. You can say again, this is less than 1 hour of job. The most difficult was to parse the HTML. Not to use the SDK. The SDK is two lines of code, and you have your LLM ready to go. You don't need to care about the infrastructure. Same happened with Google, with Amazon, with Azure, and then yeah, if you don't have very hard requirements. That how to say force you to not use commercial solutions, but the easiest again is to use one of these providers. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching the video up to this point. I hope that you find it interesting and useful for your job, for your training, for whatever reason are you watching these videos. And if so, let's just hit me a like, subscribe to the channel if you are not already subscribed, and make comments and tell me what you think about what I told you moments ago, what your opinion. And yeah, that's all. I will upload this to the repo after finishing the video, and you will be able to download the content and use it in your local environment to just practice and to review what you hear here on this video. Thank you very much, and see you soon.